You know, I've been to the top of the Sears Tower, and it's really a fantastic view, but you want to build a building a mile tall?
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jon Paula, and on today's video I'd like to discuss the Kingdom Tower, the latest monstrosity that'll be coming out of Saudi Arabia's skyline in the near future. Just recently approved by the man who has all of the money and crazy plans and apparently a very small penis, Prince Ali Wali bin Talid, the head of Kingdom Holding Company in Saudi Arabia, has recently approved plans to build a $30 billion, 275-floor, mile-high tall skyscraper to be constructed in Saudi Arabia. This is awfully scary to me as a human on the ground of Earth. I now know that in the future, there will be people that are living literally in the stratosphere. All right, so the Sears Tower, that's a pretty good height. Empire State Building, even the Burj Dubai. I mean, that building is currently the tallest in the world, and that's like 2,300 feet. And I've seen photos from the top of that. It's like you're in an airplane. You can't see people, you can't see buildings, you can't see cars, they're just little dots. And they want to build a building that is now almost twice as tall as that. Usually when you go for the record of tallest building in the world, you look at what's the tallest, and then build it slightly taller. But no, the guys at Kingdom Holding Company want to build a building that's literally twice as tall as anything else on the planet, clocking in at over 5,280 feet, making it over 1 mile in height. This is obscene. In fact, if you took an elevator from the bottom to the top, which I assume you would have to because you sure as shit aren't taking the stairs, it would take you 12 whole minutes. This building is apparently approved, and they have the money for it, and God knows they have the space and time to do it in Saudi Arabia. We don't know yet if it actually will be done, but the layout is as follows. The first 5 floors of this building will be the lobby. From floors 6 through 75 will be offices and the hotel. The next 125 floors will all be residential, and the top 80 floors will all be for alternate energy generation. Which I guess is probably not a bad idea to put some wind turbines up there because you're already up there with the airplanes anyway. And I think the reason why there's no residential zoning above floor 195 is because I don't think there's anyone in this world brave enough to live up there. To permanently wake up and look out your window and just see the curvature of the Earth. That sounds kind of cool, honestly. It does. If you can withstand like the lower amount of oxygen at those levels and the constant swaying in the breeze, sure, if you had $18 billion or whatever it costs to live there, I might try it out for a week, but I don't know if I would want to live there. But hopefully it comes out, it works okay, and it looks fantastic. I, for one, always applaud the stupidity of human achievement and just our ambition to go where no man has gone before. I think this is a bit too much, but I'm excited to see how it turns out in the future. So good luck, Saudi Arabia, with your crazy mile-tall building. Please let me know what you think about this in the comments down below. But for me, for now, that's what I think about Kingdom Tower. My name is Jon, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.